Hi students, welcome. In today class we are discussing about how to construct a hypocycloid. So you know well, hypocycloid is one of the engineering curves, especially in special curves in cycloidal. So cycloids means a rolling wheel rolls on the straight line. Epicycloid means a rolling wheel rolls on the another wheel. It's nothing but convex on the another wheel. And the third one, hypocycloid is a rolling wheel rolls inside, is nothing but concave side of that another wheel, that is called hypocycloid. Clear? So here let us consider in today problem, the size of rolling wheel is dia 40 and directing wheel size let us consider dia 160. How to construct a hypocycloid? Clear? Right? Let's go. So let us assume a rolling wheel of size 40 and the directing wheel size dia 160 mm. Clear? So you know well, similar to epicycloid, but only one difference. The epicycloid means rolling rolls on that another wheel. Hypo means rolling wheel rolls inside that another wheel. Clear? Right. So let us consider, first you draw one inclined line by center line method. Select one center O1. See, directing wheel size 160 dia, therefore take radius, given radius 80, you draw one arc. Okay, clear? That's one. Next thing, so this is the point P intersection, or otherwise contact at the rolling wheel and directing wheel. Let us consider that is the point P. Next is the rolling wheel size 40, dia 40, therefore radius 20. Clear? So from point P towards center O1, you fix the center distance 20 distance, because dia 40 means radius 20, that is called O2. So now O2 as a center, 20 as a radius, you draw one circle. It's nothing but rolling wheel. Clear? Yeah, rolling wheel rolls inside that another wheel. So this is the size dia 40 and this one is the radius 80. Clear? Right. Next thing, you know well, the theta value is equal to small r divided by caps r into 360. So small r is 20, capital R means 80. So 20 by 80 into 360. How much we get? 90 degree. So theta value is 90 degree. Clear? 20 by 80, 1 by 4 into 360. Understand? 90 degree. So therefore, place the protractor here. So from here it is 0 degree. So this is 90 degree. Or otherwise by using set square. Or by using drafter scale also. So you draw 90 degree line. So this angle is 90. So therefore after that 90, no need here, because in this problem the conditions, any conditions they not given, is nothing but one revolution or two revolution. So the conditions if not given means let us consider only one revolution. Clear? And here in epicycloid and normal cycloid, the direction also is not given, means let us consider clockwise direction. But in a hypocycloid, let us assume counterclockwise. Clear? Right. So next thing, same procedure similar to epi, the circle, the rolling wheel divided into n number of equal points. So the circle divide, for example, 8 equal parts. Starting point here, it rotates counterclockwise, nothing but anticlockwise, it rotates here. So therefore, let us assume, and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, it's rotating here. Clear? That's next thing. A circle rolling wheel divided into 8 over, similar case, that given angle also you divide it into 8 equal parts. Okay, so you know that, so for any angle that divide it into 2 power n, you know that first you bisect this. Clear? Understand? The given angle bisect, again that acute angle, once again you bisect, here also bisect. Now we get 4 angles are there, four individual parts. Once again you divided that four into each two. Like this. Clear? So the circle you are divided into n equal part, same number of n, that angle also. After that, you draw. Take O1 as the center, O1 to number 4 as the radius, but already O1 to P is there. We go for O1 to 1 as the radius. You draw one concentric arc, it definitely is passing through number 7. Next, O1 to 2, it's passing through number 6. O1 to 3, it's passing through 5. O1 to 4. And additional to that, O1 to O2, it is a center to center, so therefore you draw an arc by center line method, this one. So that's all. Now you draw that curve, same procedure. So this is here one intersection points, here these things. So this is one curve. So let us consider C1, C2, C3, C4, 5, 6, C7, C8 is nothing but CP. Clear? Next, same procedure, the die of rolling wheel is die of 40, therefore 20 as the radius. So C1 as the center, 20 radius is common for all arcs. So 20 as the radius, C1 as the center, intersect arc under number 1 curve. Clear? Intersect. Next is C2 as the center, same radius, intersect arc under number 2. Clear? It comes here, this side. Next, C3 intersect here. C4, it reaches here. C5, under 5. C6, under 6, 7, like that. After that, you join all the points. Clear? Finally, the curve comes that one. This thing. Understand? It is a hypercycloidal curve. So actually your intersection points, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, last one. So this curve is hypercycloid. Yeah. Understand? Right. In same problem, how to draw tangent and normal? For example, anywhere on the curve means you select one point on that curve, or otherwise specifically they give it this much size from center of that directing wheel, like that. Clear? So for example, draw tangent and normal at anywhere on the curve. For example, let us consider, so here just we assume this is the point. So it is a M. So you draw a tangent normal passing through that point M on the curve. Same procedure. So take how much? 20 as the radius. So M as the center, 20 as the radius, intersect arc on that center line. It's nothing but locus of center. Because all the P1, P2, P3 we get that center is C1, C2, C3. Similar procedure, now it is a reverse order. We know the point. Now we get center, 20 as the radius, M as the center, intersect arc on that center line. So here it is intersecting. Now all the C1, C2s are joining to O1, no? Similar case here also. Clear? This one, line joining. And one more thing, the normal is always from directing wheel, or otherwise directing curve itself. So in this diagram, the outermost is the directing. Therefore, that inclined line where it is intersecting on that one, that is, for example, normal starts. So now you join N and M point. This is normal. You know that tangent and normals are right arms to each other. Therefore, so N and dash, you draw a perpendicular line, that is T T dash. Clear? So this is for tangent and normal. Clear? For example, this is the curve. So from here, so this is normal, this is tangent, same procedure. Clear? Good. So this is the procedure to construct a hypocycloid. Clear? In next video, we go for another curves. Thank you.